Yeah, okay, no problem.
Yeah, I don't know, actually, I don't know that, as I said, I was like, is that something that's happens or is talked about or even allowed?
I don't know.
For a reporter, investigative reporter to wear a wire or to...
Are they allowed to
wear
a wire?
Yeah, well, not allowed, but like without...
But would you say, I mean, that's like, would you wear one?
Yeah, yeah, whatever.
I don't think so.
It sounds sneaky. Sounds like you're sneaking something.
Well,
unless you really are deep investigative, you're really trying to uncover something, and you don't have sources that will.
But there's a trust for off the record, on the record type thing between reporter and person. He's
right. I think there's maybe disreputable journalists who do that.
Well, absolutely, especially in this day and age.
Yeah,
I think that may be the case. Well, guys, happy to be able to talk to you both about this movie. I want to start with you though, because I kind of follow the Gary Webb story. It's really interesting to me. But I'm curious to know what was it about it that hooked you and made you want to tell this story.
Well, I remembered the story when the project came to me, but I didn't know the extent of how it was discredited and the whole media journalist against journalist type what happened to him.
Yeah.
I wasn't fully aware of the intricacies of that and how it did ruin him. I knew the story. I mean, he did talk shows and it was a big thing in the 90s when it broke. But I didn't know that other part. And that is the thing, though, that I think is very relevant today about media. You know, less about, you know, dark secrets about the CIA. You know, the CIA, as far as their complicity in the drug trade or however you would put it, is sort of a known thing and people report it.
Right.
You know, back in the 70s in Vietnam, you know, and also the Afghan War, so Charlie Wilson's war, that whole thing. But, and it wasn't in Iran-Contra, and I listened to those hearings. I mean, the Contra-cocaine connection never really came up.
Right.
And very few people reported it back then. So that was really it, was the sort of at war, this incredibly good, dogged investigative reporter, passionate, went at war with his own bliss. You know, like he realized his bliss was misguided in a way. Well, that's how he felt in the end.
Yeah.
Now, Jeremy, pointing Gary Webb in here, as Travis just said, this was clearly something that I think I followed this case a lot and reported on it on talk radio. And we're dealing now in a society where it's almost like a scandal a week.
Yeah.
But there weren't a lot of scandals at this time. And when this story first broke, do you remember covering this, or do you remember, or was there something that you were able to pull upon when you were getting ready, were preparing to like play Gary Webb?
I mean, there's a lot to pull on, for sure. I mean, when it is actually happening, I was blind to it. I had no idea this was going on. And that was also the impetus for really wanting me to get this out there in a bigger way than it was back then. But yeah, there's a lot to pull on from a guy who exists or existed. A lot of research that everybody has done from different writers, different journalists, and what Gary Webb investigated. I got to then his family. So I had a lot to draw on to dig into to Gary Webb and make him human, and not just define Gary Webb by what a lot of people know him as a reporter or somebody who uncovered this scandal. So we wanted to kind of make it a little bit more intimate.
Also, a guy like you always talked about, you were very, it's like, I just don't want to make a movie about a guy with an agenda.
Right.
You know, or the film to really come out like that. It was sort of just make it more of a universal experience, you know. Like you said, personal, someone people could relate to. Because we all have flaws.
Right.
And he was a flawed guy.
I'm actually, that's... it's perfect for what I was just about to ask. This kind of goes to both of you. In your research, did you talk mostly to fellow journalists? Did you talk to kind of the people in his life? Because one of the things in the movie, and you touched upon it too, was that a lot of people in his own field kind of turned on him and kind of really kind of screwed him over. Did you have a chance to talk to any people who were also in that field with him at the time who were kind of in the same, you know, in the same arena a little bit?
Our writer Peter Landesman is an investigative reporter, a journalist, and he reported on something on a smaller scale than Gary Webb, but a similar situation happened to him that way. So I got to draw upon some certain aspects of the job through him, through his eyes, who's now a screenwriter and director of his own right. Then there's Mark Bowl, another screenwriter, but he used to be an investigative reporter.